Art has always been interested in rebels, the people who do things behind the scenes, the naughty boys.
Banksy needs little introduction. He's an anonymous stencilist street artist, probably the most famous in the world. But he's also a film director. His 2010 documentary, Exit Through the Gift Shop, shows the rise of street art as a movement.
Starring the biggest figures in the street art world.
And that history is tracked through the experience of one man stumbling through it all. As though he were Forrest Gump.
You know, 12 years later, I can meet some people in the street and says, oh my God, I just saw the movie yesterday. You know, and I'm like, it's 12 years ago. And you just keep going and keep going.
You could say that the film was made for archival reasons, given the impermanence of street art.
Street art has a short lifespan, so it needed documenting. You know, we all needed someone who knew how to use a camera. I guess Terry was in the right place at the right time, really.
And maybe it began that way. But what's revealed over the course of the film is this pointed edge, this criticism of the commodification of street art that was once outside the mainstream.
It's not about the hype, it's not about the money, now is the time, you need to get your film out.
Banksy's film frames him as poking fun at the fact that street art was considered a lesser, even harmful form compared to the more traditional. And because of his success and a wide variety of factors out of his control, he attracts a perceived value intrinsically. A value he rejects, as he sees this judgment as rarely being tied to the true merit of the artwork, as one big con. Imagine it, you're making artwork to stick it to the man, and the man starts selling it for thousands of dollars. And maybe that inspires artwork like yours that doesn't stick anything to anyone. Nice job, Robin Hood. Even now, Banksy's still at war with hype, and likes to fight back with pranks. And some think that this film was consistent with those pranks. That it was a constructed argument, emphasis on constructed. Namely, that it wasn't real. Sorry for trying to get you invested in that story in the first place.
Why is it we can feel so robbed when someone tells us a story we just heard isn't true, and yet so satisfied at the end of a fictional novel?
My leading question is this. How does the presentation of Exit Through the Gift Shop as a documentary that could be fake assist its criticism of commodification? In other words, what does questions of the film's obfuscation of authenticity as a documentary in turn reveal?
Oh, ich sag immer, Film ist 24 mal die Lüge in der Sekunde im Dienste der Wahrheit. Oder im Dienste des Versuchs, die Wahrheit zu ergründen. Ne? Also, weil ich weiß auch nicht, was die wirklich...
Now, in order to understand the history of docufiction, let's wind the clock back some 117 years. Creating fiction and insisting that it's documentary is an old tool. These blacksmiths are not really blacksmiths, they're actors. And let's not even get into the suspension of disbelief that we employ for fiction films.
Almost any story is almost certainly some kind of lie.
Hopefully that softens any sense of betrayal on the part of the author, rather than makes it worse. Back to 2010, the anonymous prankster Banksy doesn't exactly elicit transparency. But I don't necessarily buy that Terry Getter, aka Mr. Brainwash, is still playing a character over a decade later. Especially when other hoax film characters have cracked in less time. Though the accusation does raise questions of authenticity, ones I'm much more interested in answering than whether the film was indeed real or fake. Is the Mr. Brainwash persona not a character? Is he not someone represented through the constructed medium of film? Surely someone aware of a camera is someone performing, and Getter seems to be someone defined by his camera. You could say that reality was shaped by Banksy to deliver his criticism on a fact of reality. But let's be clear. To me, answering whether I think that this film is real or fake would be about as productive as answering what I think these things are. Something that's revealed through questioning the film's authenticity is the thematic purpose in the film playing double. Banksy takes issue with those who can't, or won't, distinguish between the real and the fake. Let's configure what we mean by quality and realness in relation to art. Quality art is art that holds a certain aesthetic value. Now, there's many arguments on how you should make aesthetic judgments. Some are systematic. Monroe Beardsley describes a work's unity, complexity, and intensity as the grounds for judgments and the only grounds for judgments. And some are against interpretation of meaning altogether, seeing quality as something that can only be described in and of itself. But most would agree that quality is something latent, to be drawn out of artworks, and thus something that can be obfuscated.
I feel like in film criticism, very much like in art criticism, there is a role that seems to have been almost forgotten, and that is that to say, okay, this filmmaker is lying.
Hence my comparison of quality to truth. The conflation of these terms brings out one of the more complex messages of Exit Through the Gift Shop.
If you didn't have an art market, then fakers could not exist.
Considering these terms, Banksy takes issue with the auctioneer, who manipulates the intrinsic value of an artwork, and the art collector, who is informed by this value rather than by the artwork's merit, or the art audience, who may not be able to distinguish real merit from the suggestion of merit, the critic for the same reason as the audience, or indeed the artist. Banksy constructed a narrative with his film for the audience to take as wholly truthful, or at least meaningful, while it lasted. Let's return to this analogy. The film is enriched in its duplicity. It is not either an archival documentary that manifests as a comedic critique or a well-acted critical prank, because it might as well be both. One viewing may yield one interpretation, the next another. Exit Through the Gift Shop has been considered the film to codify a subgenre, the prankster film, and there's more distance to go with that idea. I feel like the film teaches us that a documentary that both insists its authenticity and invites doubt is one of the most effective and unexplored modes through which to deliver criticism in film, because it makes your audience active. Introducing ambivalence and doubt makes them stop and consider what they buy and don't buy.
He's kind of the rightful heir to Andy Warhol, in a way. Andy Warhol made a statement by repeating famous icons until they became meaningless, but then Terry really made them meaningless.
Then that quality can extend to their assessment of the art. What do they buy? And what do they not buy?